Hello guys, welcome to CatMed. This is our class 13. So in this class we are going to discuss the drafting workbench 1. So some of the objectives that we are going to cover in this workbench are like how to start a new file in the drafting workbench and generate views using the view creation wizard and so on. These are the different topics that we are going to cover in this drafting workbench. So step by step we'll go. So first of all, let's start with the creating a new file in the drafting workbench. So for that, you can go to this drafting workbench. So by going to the start mechanical design, and you can search for drafting. So where is it? So here is the drafting. So by clicking on that, we will be redirected to the drafting workbench in CATIA v5. So then it will be asking the standard, the different drafting standards. So by default you will be using the ISO standard, and even the sheet style, the different formats of drafting sheets. So you can select any of these. So A0, A1, A2, A3, A4 sheets. So let's go for this A4. And the format, you can see the paper size and all, and scale, you can see the scale, you can even edit the scale if you want. So by default it will be 1:1 scale, and the orientation is portrait or landscape, you can keep it. So you can even use this if you don't want to change any default settings or options here. So you can just hide when starting workbench, you can highlight this one. So by highlighting this one, so from the next time onwards, if you start the drafting workbench, you won't be seeing this bar here. So this new drawing will not be shown from the next time onwards if you select this option. So I don't want to do that, so just click OK. So that I will be redirected to the drafting, directed to the drafting workbench. So now currently I am in the drafting workbench. So this is how the drafting workbench looks in the CATIA v5. So this is the sheet that I have selected, A4 sheet, which is an ISO standard, and it is in landscape orientation, it's not a portrait. So I selected for landscape. So this is how it appears like this. So before going forward into this, let me clear you, there is a different ways of entering into this drafting workbench. This is the one way of entering. So coming to the next way, so just close this one. So if you see here, there is a drafting workbench option here in the workbenches toolbar, you can find it. So by directly entering into this drafting workbench, so the same option will be shown earlier. So by just clicking on this OK, you will be redirected. By just clicking OK, the same thing happens here. So these are the two ways of entering into this drafting workbench. So before that, if you want to go more theoretical, you can see that 2D drawings is the most important part of the manufacturing system, because they are required by a machinist for manufacturing on the shop floor or in the tool room. I hope you got it. So actually the one of the most major advantage of working in CATIA V5 is its bidirectional associative nature. So what do you mean by the bidirectional associativity nature? So it is nothing but you can, so if you have done any modifications in the model after creating 2D drawings of that model, so if you have done any changes in the model, now so you can see, observe automatically the 2D drawings will be adjusted as per the changes you made in the model. So that is nothing but a bidirectional associative nature. So the changes can be done in both sides. So one side, if you done any changes, the reflection will be, or the changes you can observe in the other workbench also. So this will be applicable in part design workbench, on assembly design, drafting, whatever may the workbench, if there is a link between them, they will be automatically updated as per the updated model. So that is nothing but bidirectional associative nature. So I think I have told this bidirectional associative nature in the designing and assembly design and the part design workbench, how they both are linked to each other. I think that this terminology has been used in that also. I have already told you in my previous classes. So let's get into it. And one more thing here is, in CATIA V5 drafting, there are basically two types of drafting. The one is generative drafting, another one is interactive drafting. The generative drafting is a type of drafting in which the 2D drawings are generated from the 3D models or assembly model. So from model to the draft, 2D sketches, this process is called generative drafting. Whereas in interactive drafting, you will be creating the sketches by using the 2D sketching tools here, like generating by using the 2D sketches options. Like here, if you see in the inset geometry creation, there are different 2D sketching tools here, like lines, points, circles, profiles, curves. So by using these 2D sketching tools, you will be creating the 2D sketches in the drafting workbench without the need of the 3D model. So that is nothing but the interactive drafting. The first one is the generative. So we'll see firstly the generative drafting. So for that we need a model, a part model or a assembly model. So we'll take a quick example of a part model. So from that we'll be generating the sketches, 2D sketches of different views. So let's get into it. And one more thing you need to take care of is, so this is a sheet in the specification tree. If you see the sheet one, you can right click on it. So you can see here, activate sheet, hide or show, the different options here. So just go for the properties. So in the properties, you can find the name of the sheet, you can vary it, the scale you can change it, and the format even you can change here itself, and the portrait. And the important thing is here the projection method. The two different projection methods, the first angle and third angle. So usually go with the third angle projection. So just clicking apply. Okay, so now it is in third angle projection. So how to get the by using the generative drafting. So just go for this, there is a view creation wizard here. So you can directly go for the, click on this view creation wizard, or can find it in here also. Go to insert, the views. If you go here, there are different options here. In this, see, you can see the wizard here, wizard. So in this wizard, just click on the wizard, and here you can see different options on the left side. So the first one is the first configurations. There are different configurations in which the you want the 2D sketches to be generated. So the configuration 1 using the third angle, and the configuration 2 in which you can see the left side view and the top view, the front view. So it's a configuration 3. So whatever the configuration I want, I can directly go for the configuration. So if I select for this one, configuration 3, and again we can just move it to the right side. View will be on the right view, on will be projected on the right side itself. That's the you know that because it's a third angle projection. So if you keep it in bottom view on the top, it will be the first angle, so it will be preferable. So you can see the small green color boundary here in the on the front view. The reason is these two views are connected to this front view. It's like a main view. So if you just move the right view, you can see they are moving separately, whereas if you move the front view, yeah, and it is moving separately. I think this will be reflected after creating the 2D sketches itself. So here the let's go for it. Yes, so you can see the minimum distance between each view is 40. So it's the distance between these two views and these two views. So you can change it. So here you can see here the projection views linked to the main view. So main view is the front view here. This is the front view, is the main view. That's the reason you can see the green color mark is indicating that it is a main view of all the projected views of the. So click on the next, or else you can see if once the other stop isometric roll that. So here also you can see this front view is the main view here. So just click on the next option, then the wizard step 2 of 2 is arranging the configuration. So now here you can add some more views if you are needed any need, like left view, you can add left view, and the isometric view, you can add this done. If you want to add, keep on adding the some other missing views like top view on the rear view, like that. So if you don't need it, just right click on them and delete it. So you can if you delete the front view, and if you want to let's you can then select the front view here again and just keep it here. Right click, select, right click, delete, right click, set as main view. So just finish it. So now you just need to open the go for the Windows option, and there is a other file opened in the different window. It's you can see the window naming the motor housing. You can just select the window so that if you place the cursor on the part body, you can see the preview here in the right side here, indicating it is a oriented view preview. So in this preview you can select whatever the face of the plane you are selecting, that will be made as a main view. So based on that main view, you will be create the side views and front views are rare views, what are the views you want to, that will be generated automatically based on the selection of this main view. So for this main view, you can select them, select the main view by just keeping the cursor on the model itself, or else you can just go for the different planes here. Just select the planes, type of plane, widget, etc., or simply by keeping the cursor here, just selected this one. Sorry, so in this, let's click on this. So as soon as this is selected, you can see it will be redirected to the drafting workbench, and the views, this view which you have selected will be represented as a front view, and the remaining views are generated automatically based on the configuration 2 or 3 or 1, whichever you have selected. So I select, these are views that I got here. So you can even see here there is a panning for this rotation. So there's a blue knob in the upper right corner. So from this knob you can just do some adjustments of the main view. So with respect to it, the side views will be oriented, and even you can rotate the directions to the views itself. So these are what we can do with this blue knob here. So just click on the sheet, so you can find out the views have been generated. So adjust them to fit on the sheet, and coming to this, you can drag the views individually, because you know they are not the main view. So if you just drag it, you can drag them individually, whereas if you move this, select this main view boundary, and just if you try to drag it, you can see the all the views are just moving with respect to this main view. So this is the use of the main view. So if you want to change the bits, you want to change this the side view into your main view, just right click on the view which you want to turn them into the main view. You just select this and activate view, then this right side view will be turned into your main view, and you can just view positioning. So this you can do it individually, whereas this this right, it's time to select this, right click on this and view positioning, position independently with reference view, set relative position, set relative positions. So we can just again right click view positioning according to the reference view. Then you can right click view positioning. So Propose so here the one thing that I found here is that you cannot change the other views into the main view because they need to be selected at the first place. So whereas you can just do one thing here is you can just turn the other views into by activate view, selecting the activate view, you can turn them. So they can see the border has been changed into the red color from the blue color. So from this you can like insert views projections, and you can project the activated view. See, you can project this activated view. So this view created from the rear view created from this activated view, which is nothing but the right view. Whereas if you want to insert, go for insert views projection, and in this again projection, if you want to try to create the so whatever the views that you are trying to create, top or bottom, they are all with respect to the activated view. So that's all we can do. Cannot change the this right side view into the main view, whereas you can activate a view just for creating other views with respect to this activated view. So that's it. I hope we'll end this section for today, and in our next class we are going to see there some other options, so and go further into this drafting workbench and see what are all you can plan from this. So hope you enjoy this section, and let's see in our class 13 part 2 in our next section. Bye bye.